Hello everyone, I hope you all are fine and safe. So in this video we are going to see the solution of section B of chapter number 8, framing of constitution and its feature. So without any further ado, let's begin with the question number 1. So the question number 1 is, what are the ideals stated in the preamble of the Indian constitution? So the answer is, the preamble proclaims the intention to establish a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic in India. It states the objectives to establish social, economic and political justice. It states the resolve to grant freedom of thought, expression, faith, belief and worship. It assures equality of status and opportunity. So this was your answer number 1. Now question number 2. What is universal adult suffrage? So the answer is, universal adult suffrage means to give the rights to vote to every individual who has attained the prescribed age, not to discriminate in the grant of these rights on the basis of religion, caste, race, gender, education, income and wealth, to exclude the persons with unsound mental condition and those disqualified by the law. So this was your answer number 2. Now question number 3. So the question number 3 is, India is an integral and invisible federation. How? Explain. So the space given was very less, so I have taken a picture of the answer. So you can also write this answer in your notebook. So the answer is, India is a sovereign state. Second point, the ultimate power is with the people. Third point, there is no particular regime of any one particular person or group. Fourth point, voters can elect member of parliament, member of legislative assembly in state, representative, sarpanch on the basis of universal adult suffrage. Last point, as per constitution of the country, it frames its own policies. State cannot be separated from union. Thus, we can say that India is an integral and invisible federation. So you just add this line as a last point of this answer. Now question number 4. Political equality is incomplete without social and economic equality. Explain. So the answer is, in the 42nd amendments of constitution, the word socialist was added, and by getting social and economic equality, aim of establishing welfare for the country is kept. Second point, inequality of income should be decreased among people working in different areas and profession. Third point, everyone should have equal opportunity by feeling proud of getting facilities and provisions from society, and thereby eliminating the discrimination of rich and poor, and standard of living and standard of life can be uplifted. Thus, by establishing social and economic equality, political equality will be automatically established. Thus, we can say that political equality is incomplete without social and economic equality. So, add this line as a last point of your answer. Now, moving towards the next question, question number 5. Preamble serves as a compass. Explain. So the first point is, the preamble as a soul of the constitution is also an important necessity. Second point, to understand the framing of any law or its interpretation, preamble gives proper guidance. Third point, to understand the policy behind the framing of any law, preamble plays an important role. Next point, the preamble is a useful tool to avoid the trouble in the interpretation of the constitution. Next point, when any ambiguity or obscure detail in law arises, preamble helps in understanding and interpreting the law. Last point, thus the preamble serves as a compass to understand the provision of the constitutional law. So this was your answer number 5. Now next Question number 6. India is a secular nation. Explain. First point, India is a secular country. It can never become one particular religious country as per the provision of the Constitution. Second point, India cannot involve any secular activity with religious activity. Third, the citizen of the country has a freedom to choose his or her religion. Fourth, the country cannot discriminate a citizen on religious basis. Fifth, equal job opportunities and political rights to the citizen are given without any religious discrimination. Hence, we can say that India is a secular nation. Now, question number 7, explain the following words. So, the first is dual citizenship. In federal states like the USA, citizens are given dual citizenship. They are citizens of the United States as well as of the state in which they reside and register as votes. Although India is a federal state, there is no dual citizenship. Second, parliamentary system. In a parliamentary system, the parliament is a supreme authority representing people. The legislature at the union is the parliament. The parliament is bimeral. Bicameral means it has two houses, upper house as a Rajya Sabha and lower house as Lok Sabha. Number 3, union list. In the scheme of division of powers between the union and the states, 97 subjects assigned to the union government have been included in the union list. The union parliament alone can make laws on these subjects of national importance. Okay, the N is missing, so just mention N and the word is national. National importance such as defense, external relations, etc. Now, number 4th, socialism. Socialism is an ideology which advocates egalitarian society and a welfare state. It is opposed to concentration of wealth, economic disparity, and exploitation of the poor by the rich. It advocates state control over all the means of production. So, this was your solution of section B. If you have any suggestion, doubt, or query, you can let me know in the comment section. So, I will see you in the next video. Till then, bye-bye. Take care.